Let's get to the phones now with Jack Damrell from the Oklahoma Turnpike Authority.
Good morning, Jack. So tell us, how are road conditions on the turnpike?
Good morning, Katie. Right now we're still looking at slick and hazardous conditions. Most of our turnpikes are snow covered at this time. We're continuing plowing operations with all of our crews out. In fact, we just switched out some crews on a couple of turnpikes, but we will continue plowing operations probably most of the morning. And so we are asking people, if they don't have to travel, obviously, to stay home. If they do travel, watch our snow plows, because many of them right now are driving in tandem. So they'll either come upon two or three of them at a time. And so we're just asking people to slow down and take it easy, because we are looking at slick and hazardous conditions.
You know, Jack, we showed viewers earlier this week that big new gadget you guys have, that huge snow plow. Can you explain what that does and why that's a good tool for you guys to have?
Yeah, exactly. This is definitely a good tool for us, because it covers 26 feet of the roadway. So basically, one truck can cover both lanes of traffic. Obviously, we have one on the Turner and one on the Will Rogers. Those are four-lane roads. So when it's deployed, it'll cover both lanes of the road. In addition, it can also detect the temperature of the roadway. It has laser beams on it. It has cameras on it to see what's going on. And also, it can drive faster than your normal snow plow. Normal snow plows, on average, go 25, 30 miles an hour. This big truck can go about 45, 50 miles an hour. So it does help us clear the road faster. You know, it's not a savior yet. We need more of these, as, you know, our authority's been generous to us, been able to buy some more for the upcoming budget season next year. So as we get more of these online, it will definitely help us clear the road faster.
So, Jack, obviously schools aren't in session. Some colleges are canceled, too. Are you seeing less traffic on the turnpike? And what would be the recommended speed limit? Obviously, you don't want to go as fast as the posted signs.
No, Wendell, that's a good question. You know, I've actually been on the Kilpatrick since about 2:30 this morning. Took my wife to work about 2 o'clock, just like you guys. She works at a TV station as well. So I took her to work. Traffic there, we had no traffic back around 2:30. Now traffic is picking up pretty heavily. And they're going about 30, 35 miles an hour. You do have those guys out there who think they can go quite a bit faster. And we've seen a couple, you know, slide off into the ditch. So I would recommend about 30, 35 miles an hour. Once we get these roadways plowed, then that speed will increase. The truckers, they're still going at a pretty good speed. We want them to slow down as well. Because, you know, when a truck goes by you, it's pretty scary. And there's a lot of people out here who aren't used to driving in this kind of conditions. And so when one of those big rigs drives by, it can really jar that car around and scare them a little bit. So we ask everyone, including the truckers, to slow down.
Okay, thank you so much. We appreciate it, Jack. Like he said, it can be a little scary when those big trucks go by and they kick up all that snow. But we're going to stay on top of the road conditions for you. We have our crews out all across the metro.